but they are going to download this video, so when they will download it, they will pay it, so we will see them the next one, okay? But in order to don't waste more time here and finish in a good time, no? Because I mean that in 1 hour or so we will have, we would like to go to eat something. So let's continue. And then, as I told you, they will play the video. Okay, now, before, we are going now to give our counterpart to our guest from Dominican Republic. So we will do a similar part. I mean, I will start with a small lecture about Dubai, and then our students, they will present also some of their works that they have developed during this year here in Dubai. Okay, so we can see in this way, we can see both sides, no? I mean, your point of view of Dubai, I mean, Dubai from your point of view, and then also you can start to understand our point of view, I mean, the point of view of people that which is living here. So, just a quick presentation about Dubai, guys. So, first question would be, I would like to ask you, if you know what is this, what is the subject that we have here on the the real question is, when do you see that this photo was taken? We have some good students in the 60s. So just 50 years ago, Dubai was like that. It was just Deira, Bur Dubai, Sindaga, and the creek. Something especially maybe for our students is not very strange because they know the history, but especially for the foreign students, when we saw this picture, when we saw this image, is really astonishing because everybody has these images on their mind when they think about Dubai, no? This or this one, no? We are always thinking of Dubai is this, no? All this skyscraper, all this light, all this city with all this density, but nobody think that just 50 years ago, 5 decades ago, Dubai was like that. Dubai was a small village of traders, of pilgrims, and just fishermen. Just that, nothing else. Here you can see how it was the city. There was no road, there was no telephone, there was not even a TV. There was, during the 60s, when was the first building built on concrete. Until that moment, everything was built with the stones, with coral stones, or with branches of palms. Those are more images of Dubai in that moment. Here you can see, for example, the poor people, they live in these kind of houses that they are called barasti, made by them with the fronts of the palms. And the rich people in these kind of houses that they were built with coral stones. But then here we can see two of the main characters of Dubai. One is the previous Sheikh, and this is John Harris, a British architect. When the previous Sheikh, the Sheikh Al Maktoum, became ruler of Dubai in 1958, one of the first things that he decided was to hire an architect and to start to design the new Dubai. Because as we have seen, the Dubai that it was previous, it was a small village, no? But he was this foresight, let's say, of how Dubai could be in the future. No? This is the first map that we know about Dubai. This is a map of the 90s, but here you can see that Dubai, in the 18th century, here we can see that Dubai was just this small part here in Old Dubai. Okay, there was nothing else in the 18th century about Dubai. Then this is the map of Dubai of the 50s, as I showed you on the images. And here we have the first master plan. The first master plan that was designed by John Harris in 1958. We can see that here is the old part of Dubai with the Deira, Bur Dubai and Sindara, and how he started to design, how he started to extend the main lines of the old Dubai into the new Dubai. But what happened? This is, as I told you, 1959. In the 60s, 63, the oil was discovered. And in 66 and 69, they started to sell the oil. So they realized that Dubai, that master plan was very small. So they designed another master plan. This is a new master plan, so you can start to see, I mean, the different master plans, how they realized that the first view of Dubai was small and small. But then with all these incomes, especially coming from the oil industry, but also then with the tourists and with the finance, they started to make to see a new dimension for Dubai. Just to show you the different master plans, so you can start to realize what is the different in dimension, no, in quantity. Okay, for example, here we can see that the first master plan was just this small spot that we can see here. And now it's not a master plan of a city, but it's a master plan of a territory. Just a few images to show you, no? This is the old Dubai. Here is Deira, Sindara, and Bur Dubai. Here then in the 90s, we can see that Dubai has been extended all around the coast. Here just in 2000, 5 years later, can you see that we can see from these images more than city, but here, 5 years later and 3 years later, can you see the amount of density just in 15 years that Dubai has reached? No? Anyway, what I want you to especially, I mean, what I want you to show you now are just, I would like to walk through the history of Dubai from the 50s to nowadays, just showing you a few of buildings, a few key buildings that I think that they are the most important through the history. So I am also glad that for you today is the first day, so I can show you some of the main buildings of them in this next week that you are going to be here in Dubai. I'm sure that you will have the opportunity to see them. This is the main, the one of the first buildings that we have had here. And this is this element. This was the main, one of the key buildings that we have, because, I mean, imagine that city, the city of the 50s, just a small hut, a bunch of huts, a bunch of small buildings. They don't have even roads. So when they started to build a road, one of the first issues that they built was this roundabout. That it was one of the first import element from the British, and it was the first symbol of Dubai. This roundabout, this clock tower that you will find in Deira. On infrastructures, they started to build other buildings that they need, as for example this the terminal one of the airport. I don't know which one have you landed yesterday, but this is the you can find actually. If you go to the terminal one, you will find this terminal, no? I think that these are very interesting because imagine, again, in the 60s or the 50s, when Dubai was a small village, they built this kind of modern architecture, no? An architecture that is also interpreting both things. Modern architecture, but also the traditional ideas, for example, like the Mashrabiya that we can see here, this kind of lattice, Okay. Hospitals. These started to be hospitals. In this case, John Harris, you remember the architect, the British architect that I told you, he built especially some of the most important buildings in this area, no? This was the hospital that it was before that. This element was the hospital for the Dubai in the 60s. So, I mean, they need to build all this infrastructure. So the first issue that they need was to build all these main elements that a city and a society needs, like for example, this kind of hospitals. No, again, reinterpreting this masrabia that is this window with this lattice, you know, no? So we can see that they cannot see us, but also for the weather. The light can come out, but in a controlled way. We can control the amount of light that comes in, no? Another hospital, just a few years later, they built another hospital, in this case, in a more horizontal way, using a very functional scheme like this that is surrounded by a courtyard, some images, again reinterpreting some of the main features of the Islamic architecture also. Another building, banks, they need also banks in that moment, so they started to build banks. I think that this is still you can find it in Dubai. I think that is very interesting because you can see that outside is just surrounded by this lattice, okay, by this kind of recess array that control again light and views, that here in Middle East is very important, light and views, okay, and then you can open whatever you want behind that, okay, because you control the two most important issues, that is again light and views, with the external scheme, with this kind of lattice, okay? You can find, as I told you, this map nowadays, no? Here we can see also that the structure is outside, okay? So it's holding up all this scheme, this masrabia scheme, and then behind that you can open everything, glass, floor to top to bottom if you want, okay? More infrastructures, basic infrastructure, hotels. They started to build these hotels. We can still find this hotel there. But I have tried to bring all the, most of them, the original images, because most of them nowadays, they have been redesigned, let's say. And in this case, one again, of the most important interesting issue is the lattice, the double skin that they are using here, that they is giving this kind of neutral, abstract image of this building, okay? And one of the, here you will find, this is the Greek, you will find here this, nowadays, again, this hotel, but one of the most interesting space of this hotel is also the courtyard, the inter courtyard that you will find there. Okay, if you have the opportunity, go there and take a coffee dust in that culture, in that internal culture, because it's also very interesting, especially. More hotels, in this case, they are playing more with the volumetrical mass and volume issues, no, here. But especially the most important building in that, the most important basic building in that moment was the World Trade Center. World Trade Center, they built the John Harris again in 79. He built and designed this element, this tower of 39 stories, that it was during some decades the tallest building in the Middle East. And it was designed in the middle of nowhere, 30 kilometers away from where the city, Dubai, in that moment was just near the creek, okay, in the neighborhood that they are called Deira, Bur Dubai, and Sindara. And 70 kilometers away, in the middle of the desert, as you can see here, they built this along one street, one road, that it was the most important road, and nowadays it's still the most important road, which is the Sheikh Zayed Road, which is the road that connects Dubai, the old Dubai, with Abu Dhabi. And along all that road, that is parallel to the coast, to the sea, Dubai has been developed. Dubai has grown along that road. Okay, so in that case, it's very interesting because the previous shape, they have this foresight of the of how Dubai would be, and here instead, the city, instead of building this element, financial, especially financial building, okay, but also with a hotel and so on, instead of building it on the old city to increase there the density, he said, no, let's build this away because I want that Dubai has to start to grow to that direction. Okay? Here more images just to show that it was again in the middle of nowhere. And again, I think that one of the most interesting parts of this building is the use, again, the interpretation between the traditional and the modern architecture, no? Here the use of prefabricated elements, plus, again, these deep facades of the traditional facades that we have here in the Middle East. Why? Because of the sun, again, because of the light, to control the amount of light that comes inside, okay? This was also the World Trade Center had another building nearby that it was a hotel and a convention center and a parking, okay? Here this photo is taken from the top of that building. Here you can see that this is the Sheikh Zayed Road. Here is the sea. Here there are not houses, this is just vegetation, okay? And you can see that all around all this road, there were just our World Trade Center, these apartments that they were apartments for the people who will be working inside that World Trade Center, so I mean for expat, and then just another two more buildings. Nothing else until to Abu Dhabi, 100 kilometers away. Okay, so just to show you how was Dubai, okay? Then, once Dubai started to be established, especially in the 80s, I mean, with all the incomes for the oil industry, other industries also, and especially the finance field and the tourist field, they started to build more of this kind of building. I mean, they started to grow up, and the buildings, they continue to be, like, for example, in this case, this hotel. No? I think that you can find this hotel nowadays. It's the Hyatt hotel that you can find in Deira. I think that is very interesting because how is the approach of the architect to that path, to that element? No? How the building is not straight, but is this zigzag shape, and also is becoming lower while the building approaches the sea. No? Just to broke the scale. Like imagine now that building straight and also with the same height. I mean, it would be like here a wall, a great wall, no? I mean, just in that case, somehow you are reducing the impact of the scale of the building. No? But also imagine, again, this building in the 80s. I mean, because remember the image that I showed you of this building, which is going to be a hotel and offices and apartments. It's more or less finished the exterior, so you can see this form, okay? But I suggest you to go also to Arsenal Avenue, which is in Albasa, in the industrial area, which is one of the industrial area. But in that case, they have rebuilt, let's say, some of the warehouses for this neighborhood, artistic neighborhood, let's say, okay, that is called Arsenal, and inside. It is the first building built by OMA, Barrancura, here in Dubai, okay, after 20 years. That is this small cultural center, this small museum, okay, that is called Concrete Lab, okay. And one of the most interesting things is, again, that what they are doing is providing the relationship between the inside spaces with the outside spaces, okay. For example, we can see here, so this square can be part of the museum, or the museum can be part of the square. both cases, okay? Something that is also very new here. Another building, new building, we are just finishing, is the opera. Just built a few months ago. Just finished a few months ago. I think that this building is very interesting, not just because of the form, but because of the urban issue. How is connected this building with the city? That is something very interesting here nowadays, because before, Dubai was built by economy, by just buildings, and not by the city. Again, this museum is the Etihad Museum, has been opened just a few months ago. And again, I think that the most interesting part of this building is that this part is just the gate, the entrance. Because all the museum is under. So it's under the ground. You can open all these curtains. I think that is one of the most interesting parts. And just last three buildings, just to show you how Dubai is going to be in a few years. This is the Creativity Center, a huge neighborhood that Foster is building on the Dubai Design District. Everything, all these elements are going to be warehouses for artists, so everybody, the young artists can go there because it's going to be cheap and safe booking for them. And here is going to be one of the, we try to make a good design school. These are other spaces. And of course, the Expo 2020, you know that the Universal Expo, International Expo in the 2020 is going to be here in Dubai, in the south of Dubai. So this is the master plan of that element. And of course, as Edward said before, you know that nowadays the tallest building is the Burj Khalifa here in Dubai, right? But nowadays they are building another. This is 824 meters. Okay? They are building in Jeddah, in Saudi Arabia, another building taller than this one. We don't know the height because they don't want to say the height. But it's going to be taller than the Burj Khalifa. And they say that maybe taller than 1 kilometer. So, as Dubai want to have the tallest building in the world, they are designing this one. That this is the tower, designed and answered in this case by a Spanish guy who is called Santiago Calatrava. And we don't know still the because it's a secret. Again. Because it's a kind of competition to be, because if you say now that it's going to be this to this height, maybe the others they can make it taller and so on. Well, anyway, these are just the latest buildings, and now what we are going to do is I want to call all my students, so we are going to show you some of our projects that we have designed here, okay? So come on guys, come here.